school's out for summer. For the next 10 weeks, thousands of students and recent graduates across the country are going to be interning at NASA. And about 425 of them are going to be interning across Goddard Space Flight Center's four campuses in various clean rooms, labs, and offices. And here in Greenbelt, Maryland, it is their first day, so let's go inside and talk to a few of the interns. Priscilla, what are you working on here this summer?
So I'll be working on research with mangroves and being able to generate the global biomass for mangroves using remote sensing.
So I'm working on the LISA Pathfinder. It's a European Space Agency mission that NASA's providing science support for. It's just testing technologies for the first gravitational wave detector in space.
I'm going to be doing database development for topological data.
I'm working on a thermal infrared sensor that is going to measure land temperature.
I'll be working at the NASA Innovative and Advanced Concepts Division, and I'll be doing a lot of paperwork, reading over people's projects and reporting it to other people.
Understanding how oxygen and other compounds work at the stratospheres of Saturn. Basically more computational chemistry that I'll be working at.
Basically I'm going to be looking at small entry vehicles entering Mars and Venus and how the heating around the vehicles being affected by different probably Mach numbers, angles, things like that.
And how did you find out about this internship at NASA?
I originally met someone through a conference last summer. I got introduced to somebody, one of the branch managers who works here, and wanted me to work for him.
The Indian Natural Resources Science and Engineering program. It's a really great program that helps many underprivileged students, low-income students.
My mentor at my university, he told me to apply for it because my work at the university is kind of related to it.
My dad heard about it somewhere and was like, hey, maybe you'll like this and you should apply, and so I did.
I was just browsing OSSI. I'm looking at the list of different opportunities. This one looked really cool and added to my list.
I've been applying for the past like 3 years actually. So when I got this, I was super excited. It's like a dream come true.
If you could send a mission to anywhere in the universe to study anything you wanted, where would it be and what would it study?
I remember hearing about an exoplanet that was completely ocean, that was maybe 10 times bigger than any ocean we have here on Earth. And we know more about our moon than our ocean, so it'd only be amazing to figure out what a whole planet of water could be.
Maybe towards the center of the Milky Way, study black holes, things like that. I find those super interesting.
Europa or maybe Enceladus. And the reason being is those are two of the most likely places in our solar system in order to find life.
I'd go to Mars to study the ice caps because those seem really interesting to me to see how they got there, what they're composed of, and how deep it goes.
I don't know. I guess anything like planetary atmospheres, things like that.
Europa, for sure. Like going to the ice in Europa. That's like one of my favorite moons and... Yeah, I feel like there's a lot of potential there.
How many of the 10 NASA field centers can you name?
Zero.
Well, you're at one of them.
Oh, so I'm at Goddard Space Flight Center.
I know there's one in Houston and in California, but I can't remember the names, though.
You're killing me. I can't.
I can name Goddard, Marshall, Langley, Ames.
Ooh, there's Goddard, of course. Kennedy, Johnson, Marshall, Ames, Armstrong, Langley. Ooh, last three. They're going to be tough. Is Dryden still a thing? Okay, Dryden, cool. Then Dryden's Armstrong, crap. Never mind, there's still three more.
Okay, so we have Goddard, Glenn, Ames, Langley, Armstrong, Kennedy, Johnson, JPL, Marshall Space Flight Center. We don't count Wallops, right, or Stennis?
I think we do count Stennis.
Oh, do we? Oh, Stennis Space Center then. Am I missing one? Yeah.
Best of the day. Congratulations.
Well, good luck on the rest of your internship this summer.
Thank you so much. Well, the interns are off to orientation. Soon after, they'll start their exciting and, in many cases, out-of-this-world projects. You can follow their accomplishments online at nasa.gov/Goddard.